إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله بلوغ المرام وعند البوك أف صلاة إن شاء الله today we are starting حديث 239. We mentioned it part of the حديث in our last lesson. حديث 239 وعن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان we say كان للدوام كان means he used to do a lot or he used to do always للدوام كان يقول he used to say بين السجدتين the sitting in between two سجدة Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to recite this dua. Allahumma ghafir li warhamni wahdini wa'afini warzughni. So Prophet used to recite that dua at the sitting in between the two sujood. Also, there's another narration. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, Rabbi ghafir li. Rabbi ghafir li, Rabbi ghafir li, Rabbi ghafir li, Rabbi ghafir li. Good, a lot. So you are saying Rabbi ghafir li without any number. Yeah. Rabbi ghafir li, Rabbi ghafir li, as long as you need to get on. But if you want to heed this dua, Rabbi ghafir li, warhamni, wahdini, وعافني ورزقني إسفنس one time رواه الأربعة have been narrated by four except the Nasai the terminologists have been used by Sheikh Al-Asqalani in بلوغ المرام if you say سبعة seven means start from right أحمد بخاري مسلم أبو داود ترمذي النسائي And Ibn Majah. If you say six, means Ahmed ibn Hanbal said in there, and other six, Bukhari, Muslim, Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, Nasai, and Ibn Majah. If you say five, means Bukhari and Muslim are not in the hadith. So Imam Ahmed and Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, Nasai, Ibn Majah. If you say four, four means Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, Nasai, and Ibn Majah. So now he said, has been read by the four except Nasai. So Nasai is not in the narration. So the four except Nasai are going to be Abu Dawood and Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah. If you say three is Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi and Nasai and not Ibn Majah. If you say Mutafiqun Alayhi, it's Bukhari and Muslim. So that's the terminology he used in the book. So now we say narrated by four. The four should be Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, Nasai, and Ibn Majah. That four he say except Ibn Majah. So Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, and then Ibn Majah. That three narrated the hadith. In here, you go to sujood, and then you come up. And you go back to your sujood. Coming up is rukn. And it needs something called tuma'anina, tranquility. If you come up and while you are on the move, go back to your sujood, that means you miss the rukn. And if you miss, that means your salah is not valid. If you miss the rukn, that means salah is not valid. So wujub raf'i min as-sujood. It is wajib to raise your head up from the sujood. وَالْجُلُوسُ بَيْنَ السَّجْدَتَيْنِ And to sit in between the two sujoods. And to sit in between the two sujoods. Bukhari narrated long hadith, say, أُسْجُدْ حَتَّى تَطْمَئِنَّ سَاجِدًا Go to your sujood until you settle in your sujood and be calm and remain in your sujood. ثم ارفع ثم ارفع and raise up your head حتى تطمئن جالسا until you sit calmly, fully seated. ثم اسجد and then go to your second sujood حتى تطمئن جالسا ساجدا. That means that sitting is rukn. To sit is a rukn and to recite the dua, some scholars saying it is sunnah, but it is wajib. Allahumma ighfirli warhamni warzuqni. So these five words, if you go back to the hadith, you see it's five words. Allahumma ighfirli, that's number one. And then warhamni, number two. And then wahdini, number three. Wa'afini, number four. Warzuqni, number five. So that five to us. That five, we want to see the meaning of each, inshallah. Allahumma ghafir li. There is maghfirah and rahmah. What's the difference? Maghfirah means sealing and hiding from others. So al-awwal, sitrul dhunubi an al-iwad. Wa-thani at-tajawuzu anhu. Yeah. If you do something wrong, and Allah seal it from others, no one knows the sin you've done it. Yeah. And then Allah is going to ask you. That's maghfirah. Rahmah means Allah forgives you and gives you mercy upon you instead of that sin. So in here, sitru dhunubi an al-ibad wa tajawuzu anhu fala uqubata. Warhamni means Allah's mercy upon me. But here, there is something close meaning in the religion. For example, if you say al-Muslimu wal-Mu'minu, if you mention both, they are different meaning. They are slightly different. If you mention one of them, the other one includes. Yeah. The other one includes. From Surah Dhariyat, yeah, when Allah mentions both mu'min and muslim, فَأَخْرَجْنَا مَنْ كَانَ فِيهَا مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فَمَا وَجَدْنَا فِيهَا غَيْرَ بَيْتٍ مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. So has been mentioned both, that means both have different meaning. But if you mention one of them, it means yeah, it covers the other. So here, Ghufran and Rahmah. Ghufran and Rahmah. If you mention one of them, it covers the other. Allah seal your sin from others, and Allah not question you, and Allah give you rewards instead. If has been mentioned both of them, there's a slightly difference. So in here, let's see the meaning of the rahmah. إذا اجتمع سؤال المغفرة والرحمة. If مغفرة and رحمة has been mentioned both, the slightly difference of meaning is فالمغفرة لفعل المعاصي. مغفرة you need because you done wrong, معصية. والرحمة means لترك الطاعات. You didn't do something required for you to do it. You ask Allah's رحمة because you didn't do what required from you to do it. عبادات. And مغفرة is if you done something prohibited for you to do it. When they both together. When one of them, it covers all the meaning. أي أن الإنسان, the person, إذا سأل الله المغفرة, if he asks Allah forgiveness, فالمراد مغفرة الذنوب الواقعة. You ask Allah to forgive you, the the actions, the sin, you've done it. The sin you've done. وَإِذَا سَأَلَ الرَّحْمَةِ if you ask Allah mercy. فَالْمُرَادُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْحَمُهُ بِفِعْلِ التَّاعَاتِ yeah. Allah's mercy for you because of your actions of the obeying. The both are same meaning and slightly different. So that's why we always be mentioning it together. Number three, وَهْدِنِي الْهِدَايَةِ Hidayah has two meanings. One, Hidayah to Tawfiq. Yeah. Allah guide you to be Muslim. I didn't guide so and so to be Muslim. What's the difference? Tawfiq. Allah gave you Tawfiq Tawfiq lil Hidayah. Allah gave you Tawfiq. Yeah. Someone Muslim, his father not Muslim. Someone Muslim, his mother not Muslim. Someone Muslim, his brother not Muslim. So this means Hidayah Tawfiq. Allah gave you Tawfiq to be guided. Yeah. That's number one. Number two, Hidayah to Ilm wal Irshad. You ask guidance to the knowledge. To the knowledge. If you don't have knowledge, or you don't seek the knowledge, how you can worship Allah? So it means Hidayah to Ilm. Number one, al-hidayah min Allah. You see some people saying, yes, so and so done a big dua, a big da'wah, yeah. He turned a lot of people to Islam. Or he won village, yeah. He didn't turn it. He done his job as a prophet, like a prophet. He done his job like a prophet. Prophets, they do da'wah. On judgment day, a prophet is coming. No one with him at all. Have he done his job? Yes. But those that didn't accept him, was Hidayah is in Allah and not from the Prophet. A Prophet is coming on Judgment Day, only one man with him. A Prophet is coming, or two men with him. So where is coming that Hidayah? It comes from Allah. Hadith mutafakun alayhi. عن أبي هريرة قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لعمه عند الموت لعمه his uncle his uncle how many uncles for Rasul Allah had who knows 10 when It started, prophethood started. How many of his uncles was alive? Yes? Abbas? Hamza? Abu Talib? And Abu Lahab? Four uncles. We are alive at the start of the prophethood. That's why uncles two believe it and two they didn't believe. Abbas and Hamza, they accepted the call of the prophet. Abu Talib and Abu Lahab, they didn't accept. But there was a big difference between Abu Talib and Abu Lahab. Abu Talib was the right hand of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Abu Lahab was against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So even in the hellfire, they are not saved. They both died mushriks. Yes. They went to hellfire, but they are not saved. The least punishment anyone can get, that's for Abu Lahab. He's wearing only sandals of fire. Abu Talib, sir. He's wearing sandals of fire. And his brain is burning. His brain is burning. So Abu Talib, when he died, he died year 10 prophethood, 3 years before Hijri. Abu Talib and Khadija, they died same year. And that well known in the seerah, they call Aam al-Huzni, the year of sorrow. Abu Lahab, he died after the Battle of Badr. At the Battle of Badr, he died. Yeah. So in here, li'ammihi, which uncle the Prophet is struggling for him to accept the Islam? Abu Talib. Li'ammihi عند الموت. He said to him, قل, say, لا إله إلا الله. أشهد لك بها. I will bear witness on Judgment Day, يوم القيامة, that you said, لا إله إلا الله. A witness on Judgment Day, yeah, you are Muslim. Say La ilaha illallah. Fa'aba, he refused Abu Talib. So Prophet, if he have power to guide someone to the Islam, he was guiding his uncle, isn't it? Yeah. When you see some of the children, they are not good. Yes, and you see sometimes mommy say, I done this for him, still he's not good. Yeah. Now there's something missing from here. She didn't do dua for him. She didn't do dua for him. So always make dua for the children. Yeah. You can't guide them. You can't guide them. But ask Allah. So Prophet Hassan, he struggled to give dua to his uncle. Fa'aba, he refused it, Abu Talib. Fa'anzal Allah, Allah revealed the Quran. Innaka la tahdi man ahbabta. Yeah. You will never guide to the right path, whoever you want, however you wish. Lakin Allah yahdi man yasha. Allah guides whom He will. Allah guides whom He will. In Sahih Muslim, عن أبي هريرة قال فإني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول recitation of the فاتحة when you recite فاتحة حديث القدسي أن الله accept what you're reciting فإذا قال if the servant says اهدنا الصراط المستقيم oh Allah guide us to the right path. Guide us to the right path. And then the description of the path. Sirata al-ladina, the path of those an'amta alayhim. Yeah. You bestow your mercy upon them. Who are they? Allah mentioned another ayah. Yeah. Al-Nabiyuna. Al-Nabiyuna. Wa-Shuhada. Wa-Siddiqeena hiya. Al-Nabiyuna. والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين that is أنعمت عليهم the prophets والصديقون والشهداء والصالحون هؤلاء those are أنعمت عليهم so you asking Allah to guide you to the right path the path of those the path of those they follow it and then you clarify that not the path of others. غيري, other than the path of al-maghdubi alayhim, those who your anchor is on them. Why is his anchor on them? That's Jewish. Because they have knowledge, They know how to refuse it. What about Alina? The Christians. They worship Allah without knowledge. So scholars said, the bad scholar is, yeah, is becoming under maghdub alayhi. The bad ignorance of those who are doing da'wah without knowledge, they are going under walad dhalim. So what da'wah you are doing? If you say that, ihdina sirat al-mustaqim, sirat al-ladina an'amta alayhim, غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قال الله says هذا لعبدي this dua is for my servant ولعبدي ما سأل and I will give my servant what he asked so وعافني I put this in the wrong place عافنا من كل الأمراض سواء سواء لكن المهم العافية من أمراض القلوب هو supposed to put this up عافية the best عافية you ask Allah is to clean your heart from the shirk and from the nifaq that's the worst disease that can be struck the best both of them they lead or they take you straight to the hellfire. So the Afi, you ask Allah, to clean your heart before your body. And that clean of the heart from the shirk and from the nifaq. If you save from that too, you'll be safe. Even the shirk al-asghar, beware of it. معنى ورزقني معنى ورزقني أي أرزقني أو الله sustain me الأكل the food الشرب the drink لباس wearing clothes سكن accommodation نكاح wife and children or husband and children كل شيء وأهم الأرزاق the best sustain you get from Allah أن يرزقك الله علما نافعا Allah sustain you beneficial knowledge علما نافعا the علم you implement and you act upon and that علم takes you to the paradise that's the best أرزاق Allah gives you صحيح ابن ماجه عن جابر قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سلوا الله ask الله علما نافعا beneficial knowledge people ask money most ask الله علما نافعا that's the best It's good to ask Allah everything else. It's Allah. But the most is ilm al-nafi'ah. But that ilm will take you to paradise. وَتَعَوَّذُوا بِاللَّهِ I seek refuge of Allah مِنْ عِلْمٍ لَا يَنْفَعُ From the knowledge which has no benefit. From the knowledge which has no benefit. الصحيح ابن ماجه عن أم سلمة أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يقول he used to say the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا صلى الصبح when he prays فجر صلاة when he prays فجر صلاة he used to say اللهم إني أسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا. Yes. Let's to learn this and recite after Fajr Salah. Allahumma inni as'aluka, oh Allah, I ask you, ilman nafi'an, beneficial knowledge. And then, wa rizqan tayyiban, yeah. And halal beneficial, halal rizq. وعمل المتقبلة an acceptable deed. Yeah. You pray now, you don't know whether it has been accepted or not. You finish Salah now, did you accept or not? Do you know? So ask Allah to accept. Yeah. And when you ask Allah acceptance, you need istighfar. Yeah. The companions, Allah mentioned it in the Quran. They pray in the night, and then when they finish tahajjud, Allah said, "Wabil ashari." At the time of the suhoor, when they finish tahajjud and they're waiting fajr, whom? يستغفرون. They seek, yeah, refuge of Allah. They seek forgiveness, istighfar. So the best thing you do is istighfar. When you ask Allah, yeah. You finish your salah. You didn't do something bad. You have done something good. And then when you say assalamu alaikum, assalamu alaikum, what do you say? Astaghfirullah. So istighfar is not only when you are doing sin. Istighfar is also when you do something good. Yeah. But have you done that completely as required from you? So, وَعَمَلًا مُتَقَبَّلًا. So, Al-Khulasa, the summary of the lesson today, is a Muslim, عن أبي مالك الأشعري عن أبيه. أنه سمع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأتاه رجل أمان كيم تبرس الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أمان كيم تبرس الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا رسول الله كيف أقول how I should present my question حين أسأل ربي عز وجل when I'm asking Allah. So when you are going to ask the manager or whatever, how you do? You write letter, you wear your tie, you shave your beard, and you come to him. To, yeah. That's what you do, isn't it? To present, yeah, the way he likes. Maybe you like to keep your khamis rest of the day, but what he likes, he doesn't like khamis. So wear your tie, shave your beard, and go write the letter and take the letter to him. So when you ask Allah how you present yourself to Allah. قال برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قل سي اللهم اغفر لي. That's the dua. وعافني وارزقني. اللهم اغفر لي وارحمني وعافني وارزقني. So this man wants to keep a heart what the Prophet telling him. So Prophet Asama teaching him. Yeah. وَيَجْمَعُ أَسَابِعَهُ Prophet collecting his fingers. اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَرْحَمْنِي وَعَافِنِي وَرْزُقْنِي إِلَّا الْإِبْهَامِ except the thumb. Yeah. So Prophet count for him four. So the man can understand and keep. And the Prophet says, Asama, فإن هؤلاء those du'as تجمع لك they will collect for you everything دنياك in this world your world you are living now وآخرتك and you hereafter everything you can اللهم اغفر لي وارحمني there's no sin upon me وارزقني allocative knowledge in beneficial knowledge. Allahumma arhamni, Allahumma ghfirli, warhamni, wahdini ala kafir Islam, warzuqni ala kafir beneficial knowledge. So you go to paradise. So nothing you are missing and you lose. So on top of the salah, also you present this dua and you ask Allah this dua. Allahumma ghfirli, warhamni, yes, wa'afini, warzuqni, mashallah. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا وعلى اله وصحبه ومن تبعهم باحسان الى يوم الدين.